Hello, one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play No Man's Sky with me, EkkiThump. We're back here on the search for Viridium. You'll recall we came to the right system for it last episode and found some straight away. Well, we found the right planet anyway. So let's head down there and see what we're dealing with. I would imagine it's underground, same way that Emerald is. Rubium's supposed to be the same. It is an exotic element, so it may not be in the first place we look. But let's see. Frenzied. Oh, shitting hell. Is there another planet in this system we can have a look on? Yeah, let's go somewhere else. Fucking hell. Sentinels will attack on sight, which means we'll get absolutely nothing done. Let's see if there's anywhere else in the system. How about over there, for instance? Ngoybebe CX108. Could be. Hope this isn't like a thing where every planet that has Viridium also has frenzied sentinels. That would be very inconvenient. Because of course I would imagine it would be the same thing then for Rubium. And we've got to get some of that as well. Right, so let's try again. I would imagine we're still a bit too high to land. Yes, we are. Limited sentinels, okay. This is more like it. Now the question is, ooh, is that it? Saw a brief flash of something underground. I dare say. Let's go over here and have a look. You know what I've not done? I've not made any more of those bloody shielding plates. It looks like we're not too badly in danger from hazards on this planet. Where is that thing I saw? That's not even anything, that's just terrain. I guess... I can see a bit of glow over there. I'm not sure if that's a cave or if that's a node of something. No, I think it's just a bit of shading on the rock. Damn it. I am assuming Viridium's going to be green because, you know, it requires a green solar system. And, you know, Virid is a greeny sort of word. God damn it, I've lost it now. Alright, well, let's try over here for instance. Alright, yeah, I guess that'll do. Well, okay. We are getting close. We're within range where the scanner can tell what I'm looking at. There we go. Yeah, it's green. So not that far underground. I think we only need about 50 for... this is for the Skywart farming recipe. But I'm going to grab as much as I can. Like at least, well, basically all of this node. I think I've got room for it. So now we know where to find it. That's basically it. There's a few globs here and there, but right. So how much did we get? 277. Fairly decent. So now we know where to find this stuff. We can come back for some more if we need it later. So let's go back to base, give this stuff to Giles. Maybe we can even pick up some plants to sell. And then we should find some rubium as well, which is more or less the same as this, just in red systems. Okay, we can probably just skip away from these pirates because we're going out of system anyway, so. Also, I did ding up the shields a little bit. So we are a bit low on iron. Oh god, where's the entrance to the space station gone? We may have to fight it out. It's alright, I've got some titanium on me as well, I forgot about that. Okay, we've got one of them. It's an encouraging start. Let's have this one next. Just put everything in there. Zinc, titanium. Okay. Go on, let's get that one. Come here, little bugger. Oh damn it, gun's overheated just as we were about to kill him, and now he's doing a bunch of damage to us. But we got him in time, nothing too serious. Okay, one more. I think we want to try and avoid shooting the space station. It might not be too happy if we did that. Got him. That was a bit lucky, just as we were about to actually run out of shields with no stuff left to recharge them with. Menace! 6 stars! 40 starships destroyed. Ooh, nice! And we've progressed in our Gek sandings. Apparently this is a Gek system, I wouldn't have known it. There was nothing to signify that. Alright, now we've got to try and find the entrance to this place again. There it is. Alright, so we made it inside safely. We've got a cargo of lemium and trophium, which we can sell, but we'll do that all at once. First we're going to get back to our home planet and hand in the viridium. So, if I'm not wrong, we were going to get the recipe for skywarp plants from this. Unless we've already got that and I'm thinking of something else. Viridium. Yes, we've got some. Ah, no, Vivilava. Here, I have the viridium you need. That's good news. I appreciate that not all of my requests are easily answered. Vivilava. This living rock is adapted to live in the most extreme heat of scorched biomes. However, it can be farmed in most environments and once established yields a small but frequent harvest. Suitable for hydroponic indoor planting. Oh, we can probably make one of those. For Vividium, I'm not sure if we have any. I'm sure it is available in this system though. Or no, it was available in the old home system. Yeah, that's the thing. Let's have a look. Oh, we're going to need some carbon anyway, we can just go out and chop trees for that. Alright, I can never remember what's in these. Yeah, only 45. It was at 100, wasn't it? Vivilava, yeah, 100. Alright, well let's grab up some plants. Sack venom. Grav balls. Mordite. Mordite and Charizogen. We'll put the viridium into storage. Right, we're going to remember if we can. Number four is bits and pieces for fuel. Now we've got one space here we can put some viridium into. Yes, I did need to save these for something, didn't I? Did I? I can't remember. Well, let's sell them. We're selling a bunch of stuff, might as well sell those as well. Right, we're going to go and look for some for viridium to plant our new vivilava. Then we're going to find a red star system. Oh, hang on. I need to restock on some iron, don't I? Iron, and we're going to get a bunch of carbon. It's useful for recharging the laser, and we also need some for the vivilava recipe, so we might as well get some here. I'll do for now. And one, two, three dead trees should be plenty. So, we might as well fly to the space station in this system. Tell you what else we might as well do, we might as well recharge the deflector shields before the pirates come in again. Right, where am I going? Space station, over here. Should have checked what Giles' next mission for us was, really, shouldn't I? Well, it'll be fine, I'm sure. So we should have at least 100k worth of stuff to flog. Not bad going for one harvest. Well, plus a bit of space combat. Hey up, mate. Right, so Candentium we're now farming, we can sell that. Sack venom, we're farming. Gravitino ball. Mordite, Charizogen. Those two green items aren't really from this session, but whatever, we'll put them on the balance sheet. Then, of course, we've got 10k worth of trophium and 2 lemium. So, good, we're getting back up there. Next on the list, fervidium. So, spadonium. Ah, fervidium. And of course, we already know that the crop on our home planet is vortex cubes and charizogen. Right, might as well land here as anywhere. What have we got then? Show me some purples. There we are. ''43, not quite enough, is it, with the stuff we've already got at home? Let's see what we've got down here. Hello. What's the camera button again? I press it so rarely, I keep forgetting. There it is. We found one species. We really haven't done any scanning on this planet. Do we get a scan off this place? Or does it just show up because it's a object and not just part of the landscape? What's that guy doing up there? That Hanivium appears to be on guard. Let's see what we've got with the Nezgan then. We trigger this, head round into the structure. We'll also check out that shed just in case. Front door, where is it? Looks like this is it. God damn it, why am I finding so many broken green crates lately? It's a Viking. Let's do him first of all, then we'll check the control panel. Yunan Kank Interloper. Itanglich, Umsonsien Kangan Abasha. Omaneum Rudo Zinzuita. Units acceptable. The warrior is silent for a second before looking at me conspiratorially. It looks behind to check for its colleagues before powering down security systems. The warrior pulls open the trade vault at its feet, which seems to be piled high with multi-tool upgrades. It indicates the contents of my inventory as a trade. Well, I'm pretty happy with my multi-tool, so fuck you. The threatened warrior buys my silence. That's better. We've got beam coolant Sigma, so... beam coolant, that's a thing. We've only... Oh, we've got the... tau of that. Have we got the Sigma? Ah, yes, we have. We've already got that. But the 1,000 credits is nice. I just don't like him, okay? He didn't say Beard Xoy. Judging by the imposing size and weapons shown on... Judging by the imposing size and weapons shown on the identification ID image that glares at me as I boot up the system, the station's overseer must have originated from a warrior race. The life form probably left long before the arrival of the beacon that now winks tantalizingly next to it. If I can enter the correct code, perhaps I can learn its secrets. So it's just one of these. So it's going to be 0592. The numbers I enter are correct. The location of a new world appears on the screen. Oh, nice! A monolith. Or a ruin. A ruin. Yeah, okay, sure. Let's go and do that. Let's check I'm not missing any... Oh, I am missing some. I don't think that's enough. We probably need at least one more. You see those little treasure chest icons? Sort of teasing me from behind the Atlas Pass door. At some point I'm going to have to figure out what I actually need to do to get the other pass. It might be that Nada and Polo are just going to give it to me when I get further down the path of the Atlas, but you never know. Or I could just wiki it, I suppose. Which I may do, because I'm starting to think I'm missing something. Speaking of missing something, Look at all these red dots. I'm definitely gonna... Well, we're not gonna bother renaming any of this stuff. But we've got lots and lots of 5,000 and 2,000 unit clusters we can get. I'm just gonna bulk upload this. Didn't I rename Ermutos Tusk though? Perhaps I didn't. Look at all these places we've been to. Yeah, these are the systems Arcane went to. Where? That's way long ago in the Let's Play. Shit, I've probably got a load of animals and waypoints I could upload as well. Anyway, let's get back into the ship and we can head off to this ruin. My heat protection is actually empty and it's eating into my sort of general hazard protection. But I'm not that worried. It's only like 46 degrees. Which, to be honest, is not that far above what a lot of places just on Earth get on a hot day. I mean, if you look at some of the really, really hot places in the middle of the desert, just for comparison for anyone who doesn't know Celsius, they would normally get up to like 41, 42 degrees in the day, something like that. And like a normal... A hot day in a city is like a really, really hot day in a city where everyone has to have the air conditioning full blast is like 32 degrees. Considering we've been to planets where it's been like 60, 70, 80. So, stones, knowledge stones. Oh, and favidium over there, let's get that. Then we'll get into the ruin. I don't think they are a computer. I think you're confused because I briefly walked under an underpass. Not the carbon. We want this. And there's... Is there favidium inside this massive cluster of... Whatchamacallits? There it is. That should be all we need. How much have we got so far? Target was 100. We've got 119, so yeah, that is all we need, and a bit more. Before we head out, we'll just check we've got the thamium and carbon we need. First, we can have a look around this place. Certain what? Certain insults. Yeah, that pretty much describes a conversation with a Viking, doesn't it? Right, let's have a look then. Runes take shape upon the stone. Burning with light, they sing to me of the Viking ancients in the language of my people. The Viking rose in glorious victory. Yet noble warriors grew tired and weak. The onslaught against the machines endured for 99 times 90 cycles. There was attrition and incalculable death, but victory eluded them still. The endless replication of the sentinels slowed, but could not be vanquished. Ooh. Seems like we're reaching a fork in the story. We'll have to be on the lookout for more Viking ruins. Certain insults motion. So So to recap, this is the point in the story where Herc could basically launch the Viking into their intergalactic war with the Sentinels, basically by calling the people who didn't agree with that war cowards. And it seems they've sort of reached a point where they've been at war with a Viking for, I mean, I don't know what 99 times 9 cycles, but 99 times 9 cycles is kind of a, it's like in the Bible where it says 90 days and 90 years or whatever. It just means a fucking long time. And yeah, they've sort of realised that any victory, if it ever arrived, was going to be a bit pyrrhic. Now we're going to the moon of this place where our base is. Which is where? That's it. Oh, that was a fucking awful landing. Never mind. Oh yes, I was going to check if I got any thamium. Yes, and carbon, yes. So we're okay to plant our vivilava. Yeah, vivilava. We've got quite a little weird alien garden going now. I wonder why some of these lights are on and not others. I bet there's some reason for that. Are these lights on the rest of them? These two have got lights and plug sockets. The rest of them have just got plug sockets. Yeah, I don't know what that's about. Hope it doesn't mean anything anyway, because I'm about to plant this Favidium here. So let's drop that off. We have got some more mature plants. The Gravitino balls haven't grown again yet, nor have the Sac Venom, and they're our big money spinners. Alright, let's check what Giles' quest is. Now that we're here anyway. Suit yourself, they are our finest crop. Indeed, with the farm thriving like it is, I don't think there's anything else I can teach you. Kukrasula, we haven't planted that yet. My Gek assistant is nibbling on a baked Kukrasula as I approach. I decline the portion they offer politely, hoping my refusal will not cause offence. I need not have worried. My farmer's is more than happy to keep it for himself. Okay, thanks for all your help. You're welcome. Thanks for the Kukrasula, you don't know what you're missing. You're welcome. Since you're not going to be doing any useful work, you're being paid in Kukrasula from now on. So enjoy that. Yeah, we didn't plant one of those. Was there a reason for that? Oops. Dicotile. I'm pretty sure those are them, aren't they? Oh yeah, puffballs as well we haven't planted yet. We've got actually some stuff we haven't done. So it's temerium to look for. Haven't planted the skywort. Oh, we have planted the skywort. It's over there, isn't it? Yeah. Bloodspain, vivilava. Kukrasula, it needs spadonium. None of that should be too difficult to find, really. It's only the albumen pearl we may struggle with. But we'll do that in a future episode. Let's see, how much time have I got left? Still got some time, so let's get back into space and we can figure out where we need to go to get this rubium. So that we can carry on down the Bill Nye / Bob the Builder lines. Then I think at some point we're going to have a base building session. Because we need to get this place a bit more tricked out than it currently is. So, let's see. Actually, we could just go over there. I am kind of wanting to head down the path of the Atlas, though. Are there any sort of... not really, are there? Just want to see if there's any red coloured stars along the path of the Atlas, but there aren't. Oh, in any case, we are going to need to make some more warp fuel before we go anywhere. No, it's going to be quite a while before the path takes us through a red system, so we might have to make another detour. Right, we've got some bits and pieces for warp fuel back at base. So rather than make it from scratch, let's go there. Oh shit, this isn't even the right fucking planet. You see, it's that bloody beacon that's thrown me off. All the trouble we went to plant those beacons so we wouldn't get lost, and the only thing they've achieved so far is to actually get me lost. I'm starting to wonder about this so-called scientist of mine. Right. We may only need one jump, but I'm going to make two warp cells. So, what's the recipe again? I suppose the first thing we need to do is convert that suspension fluid into vapor. Okay, so that only takes plutonium. Then we have to turn that into antimatter. Oh god, that needs zinc, doesn't it? Well, we've got the iridium, we just need the zinc. And then after that we need thamium. So it's zinc and thamium once again. Have these flowers regrown already from last time? It looks like it. These are the two I found last time. So they do regrow pretty fast, or they just regrow between sessions. Zinc, zinc, zinc. Walking through a pack of animals always makes me a bit nervous on this planet. Any more? We should get some more thamium. Where's that treasure chest that popped up briefly? Don't know where that's gone now. I'll just get out of here, there's hundreds of them. Oh, there's a treasure chest. I wouldn't care so much about these little crabs if they were bigger. But they're tiny, tiny things. I still haven't no luck finding any more zinc flowers. It's no wonder I was running low on it for the hazard sheet, the hazard protection units. Even when I'm actively looking for it, it's become a lot harder to find these days, whereas it used to be that you'd go out on a planet looking for stuff and you'd trip across some zinc on the way. And now, do we have enough to make another warp cell? We do not. We need a little bit more thamium. I would also like to try and start stockpiling zinc a bit. It's going to get to be a pain if I have to keep going out and looking for it every time we need to... What the fuck is that? Herox. Combined neutral alloy with uses that range from pharmacology to heavy industry. Forms the backbone of trading, so I assume it's just a trade commodity then. Things that come in units of one usually are. There's some more zinc. With the exception of Atlas stones, which apparently you do need. Well, you do need if you're following the path of the Atlas, apparently. Excuse me, lads. Yeah, don't be fooled about these things. They may look like deer or something, but they are most definitely not friendly. There was a zinc flower over here. I saw it on the scanner, unless it was that one that I've already picked. Hopefully we can get a bit of thamium along the way. It's not a disaster if we can't. Because you can get thamium just from going into space. Ah. Well, vapor is always good. Oh, and a fresh warp cell. Ready. Oh, Alice. This was a very nice area to just randomly stumble across. A whole bunch of warp cell precursors, an actual warp cell, some tradable goods. And some thamium right in our path as we head home. Oh, which hopefully we can get to before our protection unit completely dies. We can't, I don't think. 2 minutes away. I think we can make it back without dying. We may run out of hazard protection time. Let's see, 55 seconds to go. If we're going to keep going out on foot, especially considering this is a relatively serious hazard planet, maybe we should get the next sprint upgrade. I'm sure we've got at least one that we haven't installed yet. Might as well start putting some of these suit slots to more productive use. No, I think we're going to be alright. Yeah, we're just going to make it. This isn't where I parked the ship. Well, whatever, let's get inside first. Okay, you know what? Let's actually go back to Epolio of Handing. And just see if there are any red systems in the vicinity. If nothing else, it'll save us some plutonium on takeoff. Oh, damn it, I didn't put my vapors in the storage. That's alright. We can do that next time we go home. I didn't put anything in storage, what the fuck. So let's see, rubium requires a red system. Put me into, hold on, send me back. Right, into free exploration mode. Sadly there doesn't seem to be a zoom out function. You just have to sort of scan around and see what you can see. Where am I? Here? Oh, you can zoom. Okay. Yeah, so S and W, like zoom and slide and what have you. No, looks like there's no red stars nearby. Unless I'm missing one, but it's like yellow, white and the occasional green. Alright, well never mind that then, let's go we'll go back to the home system, because I'm pretty sure there was one red system within the jump range. I was just going to see if we could push along the path of the Atlas a bit, or like just push onto a new system really, but no joy with that. So teleport home, and while we're home, let's sort out the storage situation. So these are processed vapors, basically. They go into the storage. Herox we can sell. Titanium is useful. It's nice to have an oxide on hand. Mordite and favidium can go in storage. No, I'm not going to use those empty slots. I know we have some somewhere. There we go. Mordite. Right, with that done, let's see if we've still got a Matusk-Tosk space station on our speed dial. No, so it's into space. We actually have to use actual fuel to actually take off, which is just ridiculous. So I think it's that one we want to go to. Class M6. We can reach it from here. So we just need to fuel up the hyperdrive. Let's fuel up the launch thruster while we're in this screen. Okay, and we are starting to need some more plutonium again. Great. So it's class M, which means it's red. Let's go. So welcome to Sudden Renewal Assist. Spadonium and rubium. Right, let's check out what this system has to offer. We might see what that rare technology is actually before we... before we go in search of the rubium. Now that was a landing. That was a quality landing. Starting to wonder if we've been through. What the fuck? Seriously? You piss off. Starting to wonder if we've seen all of these. Well, we've definitely seen that one before. In fact, didn't we see that one last episode? I guess they had to skimp on the writing somewhere. It's just a shame that because these Eldritch horror stories, the few that we have seen, are actually quite good. They really do hit that kind of sci-fi Lovecraft note. It's a shame there's only about six of them repeated through all the abandoned buildings in the game. Oh, this encyclopedia actually works. Okay, let's see if we can get out without fucking dying to shit hanging off the ceiling that you can't even deal with. Jesus Christ. Okay, let's go looking for some rubium then. We should be looking for grids in the ground, same as on the other planet. Am I wrong, or this planet doesn't seem to have any hazards? Okay, let's take a walk. We can grab some zinc while we're here. Certainly not an unproductive trip. Any rubium? Ow, fucking hell. Any at all? That's gonna be spadonium. This was a double purple planet. Yeah, spadonium. Oh shit, oh, what the fuck? How the fuck did that creep up on me? Forget that. Oh my god. Where are... Can you actually not recharge shields directly on the exosuit? I guess not. Right, lucky we picked up that power canister. This bloody rubium's well hidden. The scanner said it was here. If I put a scanner down, and mind you, I'm miles from the ship now. I was going to say, if I put a scanner down and tell it to find me a resource deposit, will it point me to a vein of rubium somewhere? We're finding loads of spodonium. But not what we actually came for. That said, we do need a bit of spodonium for planting, so alright, let's get ourselves 100 of it while we're messing around. Ah! Christ. Oh dear. That's alright, we meant to come this way roughly anyway. Oh fuck it, I'm not drilling out of here. If I can find a way back up to the surface, we'll head back to the ship and try a look elsewhere. Should be the spodonium we need. So the ship is that way. We'll keep spamming the scanner. That's a tongue twister as we go. But not holding out a great deal of hope. Nope, no joy. Let's get out of here. Man on camera spams his scanner. That's a tongue twister for the modern age. There should be plenty of other planets in this system that have rubium on. Oh, hang on. Slow down. I want to try and find a planet that's just got rubium and doesn't have anything else. I have a feeling that the two may somehow be interfering with each other. Let's try this. Jesus, I'm nearly out of line again. What's the betting we get intercepted on the way? Amazingly enough, no pirates. Oh, spoke too bloody soon. Never mind, we're going down to the planet now anyway. I've literally never seen that happen before. We were so close to the planet that they didn't manage to complete their scan. Oh, bloody hell. Now it's a water planet. Let's see if we can find a dry bit to search on. This is alright. A lush, damp planet. Now this is the kind of place you build a base. It's a shame that we've already moved the base once and I really can't be asked to get all the materials to rebuild it again. Alright, well this episode's run way long in terms of recording time, so I'm going to have to cut it here I think. Next episode, hopefully we'll find some rubium. I'm pretty sure that's not it, but let's go take a look just to be sure. That's probably like iridium or whatever else was on this planet. Oh, come on. Can we, you're just going to sit there and tell me scanner recharging for ages. I don't know what that was. Yeah, I know my scanner isn't recharging. That's what I get for spamming it so much, but I think this is iridium. Yeah, it's iridium. So, yeah, I'm going to cut the episode here because this could take a while. Next time around, we'll have a look and hopefully find some rubium. Then we'll get back to base and we'll give that to Bill Nye. And he will give us some explosives, which should come in very handy for something. Not quite sure what, but for something. So until then, that has been Let's Play No Man's Sky, and I've been EkkiThump. I do hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game, and I will see you next time.